Hello guys, and welcome back to the Half-Life walkthrough for the PC, played on the difficult difficulty. This is the original 1998 release, not the source version. I'm Big Mac Davis, and this is Chapter 8, Honor Rail. And as you've guessed from the length of this video, yeah, this level is a very long chapter. I won't take any more of your guys' time, let's just get to the video. I'll do the promised shoutouts in the next video. Alright, let's get moving.
Freeman, I've been waiting for you. One of your scientist pals said to give you a message. You're supposed to take this old rail system up to some kind of satellite delivery rocket. I don't know where it is exactly, and the old guy was so worried about getting out of here alive, he didn't tell me. Main thing is, the military aborted the launch, so when you do find the rocket, you'll have to get up to the control room and launch it yourself. He said something about a Lambda team needing the satellite in orbit if they were ever going to clean up this mess.
So we have to launch a rocket in orbit around Earth, and that will stop the alien invasion? I'm not quite sure how that is supposed to work, but I guess we'll find out sooner or later. Press the switch, and it will raise the barrier arm, so we can proceed. Now don't go all the way on the platform in front of you, because we want to kill the barnacles so their tongues don't grab a hold of us. Would not be too good. But once that's done, we can take the elevator down. This is going to be a long mission. So here we go. We're going to go forward down the electrified water. There's nothing down the side passage there, so don't bother going down there. Now, further up along, there is a head crab, and his location is in the center of the large hallway here. Right up now, he jumped. He's up there, and you're gonna want to kill him. Or at least try to, as best you can. He'll jump from beam to beam. Well, okay, he died from the electrified water. That's convenient. So if that happens, just let him die. So we'll continue forward. Alright, now, there's an armor battery on a ledge to the right, so make a pit stop here and grab it. Now what you want to do is take the rail car further along. And once you get up this incline here to the fork in the road, what you want to do now is put it in reverse and bring the rail car back down. I don't know why this is the case, but when you go up the incline, that will change the track's direction right here, so you can take the car backwards down here. Make a pit stop here and kill the Hound Eyes. Most unfortunately, Hound Eyes are awesome. Anyway, once they're dead, there's a ladder here going down into some water, so this is kind of a secret area. So jump down into the water, and yeah, there are some leeches down here, so be careful of that. Just let them charge at you and just swing at them until they die. And if you need oxygen, you know, just raise up and you'll get some. So basically, what you want to do is just follow this pathway or this underwater passage down over here, and then take the next tunnel through here. You'll enter into a room with some more leeches, so kill them. But the main item of interest here is a dead security guard. Grab some more oxygen before I drown. And the dead security guard is over here in the far right corner, and you can get some pistol slash machine gun bullets from his dead body. So now we'll go back down the passage. And we'll get some more air, because we need it, and we'll go back down the underwater passage. And go up the ladder. Yeah, this is going to be a long mission, believe me. So anyway, now we're going to continue down the Hound Eye passageway. Well, that escalated quickly. That was a rather large scream. To the left is a room where you can kill a bull squid who's feasting on a body, but he's now dead. We can grab some bullets from the dead Marines here, so make sure to do that. Approach the blast doors. There's the bottom of the rocket that we need to launch, but we can't launch it right now. That will be way later. Notice underneath the rocket is a pair of legs. Marine legs, to be exact. And once you notice them, that will cue up the headcrabs to attack the Marine. So make sure you walk into the room and peek underneath the rocket to get his attention. And the headcrab's attention, too. But once the Marine is dead, yes, he will succumb to the headcrabs, because he starts with low health. The headcrabs will finish him off. Now, once you grab his shotgun, that will cue up more headcrabs to fall from this ceiling over there. There is a set number of them, so don't worry about that. But there are quite a few of them, so be sure to take them all out. If you want the kills. It's not really necessary if you don't want the kills, but anyway, once they're all dead, we can grab some more pistol bullets if we need them from the dead Marines there, and then continue on up the stairs. I'm going to use the shotgun for this part. There are three Hound Eyes up here, and you can easily take them out that way. And of course, one decides to infight with the teleported in bull squid. Poor Hound Eye. So we're just gonna attack the teleported in bull squid. You know, as best we can, strafe around his toxic spit if you can. And now we'll continue on past where the Hound Eyes were. Now this is a pool of water, and there's a bull squid down there, so you can use the explosive barrels to try and damage him, and then you can just kill him off with the shotgun if you want to. Alright, now just to prove a point here, I'm going to set a laser trip mine and then detonate it. Now why am I doing this? Well, because I want to have 4 laser trip mines at my disposal rather than 5, because down here, there is another laser trip mine. It's right here to the right of the green crate. Yeah, it's easy to miss if you don't, you know, if you don't have all 5 of them. Use the crate to jump back up here. Be careful of that electrified wire. You can bang your head on that. So be careful of that. Press the switch to extend the bridge, and then cross it to the other side. Kill the couple of barnacles here. They're not that difficult, and they are easy to spot. Now here we see some crates. Bash the leftmost crate from this position, and then you're able to throw a couple of grenades up there so you can kill the bull squid that's up there. The safe and easy way. And he's dead. All his chunks came flying out. Careful of this barnacle, who's guarding this passageway. But once he's dead, you can grab the items from where the bull squid was, including a new weapon, the satchel. The satchel works like a pipe bomb, like from Duke Nukem 3D. You plant it, and then you yourself can detonate it. However, there is a catch. Once you throw a satchel on the ground, you can't pick it back up, so you have to detonate it. There will be a time later where we will use the satchel, but not right now. For right now, we'll just backtrack the way we came, past all the hound eyes and bull squids, back to the rail car. This section's done, so we'll continue on. This was a totally optional side area, by the way. All it had was a cool satchel. So it is worth it. So we'll continue forward. Back up the incline. Now, your rail car can't go down the left path, but your body can. So jump off the rail car and run along the left ledge until you come to these two crates, and you can bash them for some magnum bullets. So be sure to do that if you need the bullets. So now we'll go back on the rail car and continue on. Now the right passage that we're coming up to, we're not going to go down there on foot. We'll actually go there using the rail car later on. Duck underneath the electrical wire there. And you'll soon approach the platform way over there with some hound eyes on it. Stop before you get to the left bend. You don't want to traverse over the left bend just yet. You want to kill these hound eyes first. Come on. Oh, he's hiding. Oh my gosh. That quit dawing me. That's a daw moment. That's heartbreaking. He was hiding from me. Let's take out our rage on this guy. You can shoot the bull squid, and there is a turret that will take care of him as he jumps in the air. That's rather amusing, if I do say so myself. But now we have to kill the turret, so inch your way forward on the car very slowly and get in a position where you can shoot the leg of the turret, just like we've done in previous missions of Half-Life already. Now notice there is a crane arm blocking our path, so we have to find a switch to move it out of the way, obviously, so we'll go find that switch. This is a four-way intersection. Once you pass it, stop the car and get off on the left side. Go to the edge of this tiny ledge here, and from this position, you can kill a bull squid before you have to later on. And believe me, if you don't kill him now, you're going to be in for a world of hurt later on. So I would recommend killing him now using this tactic. Once he's dead, we can continue on. Now equip the pistol and shoot the red arrow. That will change the track's direction. We're not going to go right. That will just take us back to the Hound Eye area and the armor battery. So we'll just continue forward by shooting that sign to change the track's direction. There's another bull squid. So we'll just grenade him with one grenade to wound him, and then we'll just take him out with the pistol. A grenade and pistol combination, if you will. So now we'll hop off and we'll jump crouch on the railing here to get to the top and grab the health pack there if you need it, and go down the stairs to another ladder. And you guessed it, there are more leeches down here, so have your crowbar ready and kill them all, or kill the ones that get in your way if you don't care about killing all the leeches. Me being a hard-ass OCD type person, I have to kill everybody. It can be annoying even for me sometimes, I know. What most people don't know is that, aside from the leeches and the magnum that you can collect down here, the magnum's right there next to the dead marine, what some people also don't know is that there is an armor battery over here to the side. That's what some people don't know, but it's there, so grab it if you need it. We'll go back on the rail car now, and we'll inch our way forward, but not up the incline just yet. We'll go to the bottom of the incline, stop the car, and get off on the left side again. This time we'll follow the left ledge until we get to two more crates, which we can bash open for some grenades and another armor battery. So we'll grab all the supplies, and now we'll inch our way forward up the incline. But we don't want to go too fast up the incline, because there are some barnacles blocking the way. So we want to go slow enough to where we can stop the car and then shoot the barnacles. Oh, what? Oh, that one took five. I must have missed with one of the bullets. Anyway, they're all dead. Let's continue on. And there's the four-way intersection again. But this time we're going the opposite direction. And here is where we fought that bull squid. See? Now he's dead. It's much easier on our lives. Whoops, I fell in the water. But that's okay. I was meaning to do that eventually, so might as well do it now. Hop in the water if you want to kill the leeches. If you don't want to kill the leeches, but you accidentally fall in, there's a ladder that will take you back up. So, yeah. Now look under the stairs, and there is a headcrab that will emerge from there. So kill him, grab the stuff next to the dead marine. And underneath the darkened stairs, there are two more sets of grenades, so grab those if you need them, and the first aid station. Now up here, we can bash some more crates, revealing a magnum, and there's the switch that will move the crane arm out of the way for us. So now we can go back to the rail car and go down that passageway now. So let's do that. To do that, we'll just go forward and continue going forward. And then once again, make sure to duck under the electrical wire. You don't want to skim your head on that thing. And then shoot the red arrow there to change the track's direction again, to the left side. So now we can go past the crane arm there. Now once this loading screen happens, equip the Magnum, slow your speed down. Because once you approach this ladder over there, stop the car. Once you can see the Marine's legs, and then shoot his legs with the Magnum to kill him. Inch your way forward, but do not let the car get on the platform. This is a big trap. What you want to do is go on foot for right now and go up the ladder. Then quickly hide away from the room over there, because there are two Marines there. There's their first one's dead. There's a second one. I thought I headshotted him that time. Oh, he's ducking out. Okay, I'm just going to use the Magnum then. No problemo. Just like that. Alright. Yeah, see, if you were to just come on this elevator and go up, you see the damage they could inflict? There's a health machine here, some machine gun grenades, and some machine gun bullets, and we'll go up the ladder now. Alright, so up here we'll break the crate, grab the Magnum bullets, and now we'll inch our way to the right over here, but do not come out in the open. There is a Marine over there, and he has a very particular type of attack. Yeah! He launches machine gun grenades at you. Take him down as fast as possible, otherwise he will inflict a lot of damage on you. So now what we're going to do, once that Marine over there is taken care of, is we're going to backtrack down the ladder and then get our car and go up the elevator. Because see, if we were to go up the elevator without killing any of these Marines, we would have a lot of fire from a lot of the Marines. So it's easier to go on foot and take care of them that way. And the platform that the Marines were on will also rise when the elevator rises as well. platform will just continue to rise to the next level, which we will get up there eventually, by the way, but not right now. For right now, we'll go on foot again, because it's easier. And we'll get to where that dead Marine was on that board. And there is a scuffle between Marines on the right side and Vortigaunts on the left side, so we'll let them duel it out for right now, and, you know, just to lower down the numbers a little bit. But once the fighting stops, head to the right side over here, and you want to be very careful and very alert, because there are Marines on both sides of you. Well, there's one Marine to the right, which I'm going to kill right now. He's dead. Now, there are a couple more Marines on the left side, so you also want to take care of them as quickly as possible and as efficiently as possible. Try to get the headshot. It can be rather fussy at times. But, yeah. Be careful of the Marines that do not have a mask. They are the ones that will launch the grenades. You could use this big gun right here to kill those Marines, but there's one problem. This gun isn't very powerful, and it leaves you a target. So I would recommend you just doing the tactics I used to kill them. Alright, so the next thing we're going to do is go to the platform with the Marines and grab all the guns and the health if we need it. And there's a Vortigaunt still alive. Still alive. Still alive. But he's now dead. Alright, so now we'll go to the platform with the Vortigaunts, the dead Vortigaunts, and there is another one still alive, who is now dead. Now, on this Vortigaunt platform, you can flip the switch, which will raise up the barrier arms here so you can bring your rail car down it, down the passageway. Go up the stairs nearest the Vortigaunts, and you can kill another one at the top. He's not supposed to be there, but he ran up there, probably to hide from the Marines. There's an AGV machine up here, so use that if you need to. And there is also the risen platform with the dead Marines on it, so you can grab the machine gun bullets from there. So now we'll go back down. And we'll jump across to the other side again, back to the big gun there, the big machine gun. Now, another thing to note is there's another switch there that will also raise the barrier arm, so technically you can use either switch. Carefully go up these stairs. Do not rush up them. There is a Marine on the left, and you want to headshot him. Oh, that was a headshot, but whatever. Okay. Ah, he's infighting with the Vortigaunts. Boom! That's always fun to watch when that happens. Anyway, once the Vortigaunt kills the Marine, if he manages to escape, you can kill the Vortigaunts yourself. And over here on the table is a med pack and some machine gun bullets, so grab that if you need it. Now, this side room here, you want to be careful. There is a Marine. He's always hiding in that particular corner. So don't just wade in, you will take damage from him if you don't know where he is. There's nothing in this room, absolutely nothing, so we'll continue on. And that Marine's dead over there, so now we'll venture into the supply room. I think, there are no supplies in the crates that are on the shelves, but there are supplies on the crates on the ground. But you know what? I'm going to bust open all the crates because, I don't know, because it's therapeutic, I guess. It's just fun to do. You know, it's just, I don't know, whatever. So now we'll continue forward across the bridge. Now this is a part where I want to use the satchel. We'll toss it right here. We don't want to detonate it right now, but we'll get the attention of this Marine, BAM! I detonated it just as he walked up the stairs. So that's how the satchel works, in a sense. So now we'll go underneath the dark stairs and bust open the crate to grab an armor battery and bust open the grating and go down the ladder. Some people don't know about this. Some people do, though. I would assume most people do if they want to, you know, if they do explore everywhere. And there's a scuffle above us through this grating between more Marines and more Vortigaunts. So we'll let them take care of each other. Alright, there's a health pack on the left side, so grab that if you need it. And then there's two more satchels down here, but once you grab the first satchel, a headcrab will be alerted to your presence, so kill him from the darkened shadows. The shadows. So now we'll continue back. Once everything is cleared out and you've grabbed everything you needed. And we'll go back up the ladder. Alright, so from the stairs, we'll turn right, and we'll head down this way. Now, the victor, whether it be the Vortigaunts or the Marines, is a 50-50 chance, really, I would say so. I've seen it where the Marines have beaten the Vortigaunts, I've seen it where the Vortigaunts have beaten the Marines. And from the sound of it, I think the Vortigaunts have won. Oh, whatever. Oh well, he's dead. There was only one Vortigaunt, apparently. Usually there's two or three of whatever victor there was. Now jump across the tracks to the dead Vortigaunts, and you can bust open some crates for some ammunition and some health. So grab that if you need it. Alright, and that's all we're going to do for right now. So now we'll backtrack to our rail car, and now we'll take it. The quickest way back is just follow the left path, but make sure to detonate these laser trip mines. Because that's the path that the rail car will travel down. And we're going to head in that direction, past where the laser trip mines were. Just keep hugging the left wall until you get back to the rail car. Alright, so now we'll get back on the rail car and continue onward. Squish. We'll go past all this nonsense here that we took care of very efficiently. And see, the laser trip mines were there, so it's a good thing we detonated them early. And we'll go past all this as well that we took care of. It's easier to do it on foot, believe me. So that's why we did it on foot. Now, in this area, when the loading screen happens, stop the car. Immediately. You want to get off because over that railing up there that you saw earlier, that has three Marines on it, and that's deadly. What I like to try doing is creeping up towards the red railing and tossing three grenades up there, all at different heights and stuff, to try and, you know, make the Marines run around or even kill them. And in this case, I killed two of them, because I heard two of the bodies fall and crumple. Now, I think the leftmost Marine is one with no mask, meaning he will launch machine gun grenades at you. Put him down very quickly, because he will mess your day up, and he has messed my day up over the years of playing this game. Believe me, I know. So now with all three Marines dead, by the way, if you take the rail car forward, It's a dead end. We can't go any further. We have to desert the rail car, apparently. So we'll go up the stairs where the dead Marines were and grab the ammo and the machine gun grenades from here. Now, when you enter into this next area, just walk in the entranceway, because some Vortigaunts will spawn in and will attack some Marines for you. But have the shotgun ready, because sometimes enemies will try to retreat through this passageway, and you want to be ready for that. Yep, see what I mean? That usually does not happen, but sometimes it does. And when it does, you want to be ready. I know there's a Vortigaunt still alive, and because I hear him. So now it's kind of a search and destroy type of mission now. I'm being very careful. I don't want to destroy those crates. They will be needed later on, and you'll see how that will work later on. So for right now, we're going to take the crowbar and bash open the boards. Now, sometimes this does it and sometimes not. When you approach the security guard, nope, didn't do it this time, a Vortigaunt will spawn in, but in this case, he already spawned in earlier. So yeah, sometimes he spawns in early, sometimes he spawns in when you approach the security guard, so in either case, be ready for that Vortigaunt.
Roger that. Let's run like hell.
Let's run like hell, Barney. Follow me into this next room with the soda machines. You can shoot the ceiling out right there and have Barney take care of them, take care of the headcrabs for you.
Got one.
You sure did, Barney. You are a marksman. All right, so we'll jump on the crate here, the lower of the crates, and then jump up. Another head crab in the ceiling. Nothing to say, Barney? Oh well. Alright, so we're going to jump onto the lower crate and then jump on the higher crate to get up into the ceiling. Yes, indeed. Where we can grab 3 luscious armor batteries from here. And you know what? I'm going to save the armor battery for later. I'm not going to destroy these crates just yet, just in case I need the armor later on. So we'll just continue on. We'll leave the guard here.
I'll stay here and guard this area.
Because he's of no further use to us, and we'll continue on. Now be careful. Behind this crate is a big gun. It's right there. Now, while you have him distracted like that, use the machine gun grenades. See that opening there? Fire. You have to aim it just right, but if you can manage to get it inside there, you can kill that Marine very efficiently that way. There's nothing inside these crates, and I guess because we're not coming back here, I guess we can destroy these crates for another armor battery. And we'll get some soda, because, you know, I'm thirsty. Actually, I really am thirsty in real life. Oh, gosh, a head crab in midair. Was a head crab in midair. So we'll continue on, and we'll jump the track. Surrender, Freeman. You misspelled Freeman, Marines. Learn how to spell, you dumb idiots. Anyway, be careful over there. We're not going to go that way, but there's 3 laser trip mines that you want to destroy, you know, just for fun. So approach the blast doors here, and they'll open up to reveal 2 more laser trip mines, so destroy them too. Now before you go inside the blast doors, jump on this slanted piece there, and then onto the beam. Because at the very, very top over here, you can get another armor battery. So grab that if you need to. If you need it, that is. And then go back down, and then go through the blast doors. And we're higher up on the rocket now. We're at the body and not at the base of it anymore. So we're getting up there. We're getting higher. USAF. I've always wondered what the F stands for. If anyone knows what it stands for, please let me know. I'm anxious to find out. Have the Magnum ready. As you approach the ladder, there is a Marine down below that you can get the jump on. If you know where he is, he's easy to take out. And then go down the ladder. And then go through the next blast doors. To another rail car, but we're not going to use it right now. We're going to go into the supply room to grab some supplies from here. There's a health pack here. Grab that if you need to. And if you need some patching up on your suit, there is a well-hidden HEV machine, so use that if you need to. Now to use this second rail car to our advantage. Let's take it forward. But crouch down to avoid these red lasers. Those will activate turrets in this room that we don't want to activate. What I do is I park the rail car here, then toss one grenade over there to wound the bull squid and then shoot him dead. I guess I could use the machine gun. It would be faster. I mean, gosh. Gosh, Big Mac. And there's a second bull squid up there that you can also pistol shoot from this distance. Alright. Now see, these are the turrets that would have activated if your head hit those red lasers, so it's a good thing they didn't, because now we can kill the turrets this way. Much easier. Follow this walkway along to grab some machine gun grenades. So now we'll take the car forward again, some more, to another platform with another turret. Another, not another. I always say another. It's another. Destroy the turret, and then we'll go through the door. There is a bull squid inside. So we'll just shotgun him to death and strafe to avoid his toxic spit. You're dead, Freeman. You misspelled your, you dumb Marines. And you left your can of spray paint behind. You might want to come grab that before I start sniffing it. I don't know what the hell I'm saying. Whatever. I don't even do that stuff in real life anyway, so why am I saying that? Anyway, kill the head crab and the barnacle. I guess long videos like this make me deranged. I don't know. Stupid Marines. You thought you had me, but you're both dead now. So we could use some patching up, so we'll put the rail car in reverse and take it back to the HEV machine. Now our heads can hit the red lasers because we've already killed the turrets. So we'll patch ourselves up at the HEV machine and grab the health pack from inside the supply room. It really pays to know where items are and to save items for later on. It really does pay off. So now we'll continue onward. Past this area with the door and the turret. But this next part, you want to jump off. Just jump off the rail car and then follow it down. Why did we jump off? Oh crap, I forgot about that. Okay, jump off after the loading screen happens. Jump off now. Because there is a rocket launcher wielding Marine. What happens with the rail car, if you jump off, the rail car will go down and will detonate a laser trip mine, which will kill the Marine wielding the rocket launcher. See, there's the rocket launcher there. And no, you cannot use the rocket launcher, but It is a big-looking device, if I do say so myself. So anyway, that's what you want to do. Make sure to jump off the rail car after the loading screen happens, not what I did. Die, Freeman. Oh, hell no. I'm not going to die. Never. Now, when you approach this area, notice how the rail car is stopped at the barrier arm there. When you see that, there are some Vortigaunts down the side passageway on the right side, so be sure to carefully sneak left to kill each one methodically and systematically. It's not that difficult if you take your time. And it might be more easier to use the pistol because the pistol is more accurate than the widespread of the machine gun. Maybe some... you know what? No. We're going to use the... we're going to use the shotgun. I'm going to jump over the tracks, double barrel him, and then lure the two Vortigaunts down here towards me. So yeah, handle this area just like I did, slowly and methodically, and once you cut the numbers down, you can then take care of the rest with either the shotgun, grenades, or the machine gun. It's up to you. It's all up to you. And there's a health pack over here, or health machine, rather. I don't believe there's any supplies in these crates, but you know what? Therapy. Therapy from this long map. That's all I gotta say about that. Okay, so we have to raise the barrier arm so we can get our rail car to continue on. Approach these green crates, and before we jump over them, let's detonate these two laser trip mines. Now, up above there in the ceiling, there are two head crabs right inside there. So if you want, you can take care of them, or you can just skip them. It doesn't matter. They pose really no threat. So head up to the top of the stairs, bash open the two crates. You can get a satchel from here. We're not going to use the satchel. We're too much in close quarters right now to use it effectively. So we're just going to try to headshot that Marine with no mask on, because he will use machine gun grenades on you. I can't stress it enough. There's an HEV machine, use that if you need to, and there's the switch that will raise the barrier arm for you. But that is a different barrier arm, and that over there is another rail car. We'll use that other rail car later on. We're not done with our old one yet. Let's go back to our old one. Let's go left after jumping over the green crates. And see, that's the new rail car. We'll use the new rail car later on, but for right now, let's backtrack to grab our old rail car. Because we'll use that. Just to show off a couple more enemies. So back on the old rail car, we'll take it down past that raised barrier arm. Yeah, that switch will raise up both of them. Now you want to be careful because someone... We have a stowaway on board our new rail car. That's right, a stowaway. I do not tolerate stowaways. So kill him. Now, this is a dead-end trap. Why is it a trap? Well, we'll find out. Stop the rail car! Do not proceed any further. If you do, you're dead. Basically, notice how there is explosives nailed to the wall there. And there's a Marine, a suicidal Marine, down there. You want to make sure you kill him before he does something. What is this something, you may ask? I will show you. Kill him from this distance. These explosives will kill you instantly, even from a distance. This suicidal marine will basically try to get to this switch and press it, which will detonate all the explosives, killing him and you in the explosion. Yeah, suicidal. I didn't think Americans were suicidal like that, but whatever. Oh, and by the way, if you try and take the rail car any further, after the Marine is dead, by the way, it will just stop. You can't go any further. So that's where the new rail car comes in handy, but we had that stupid stowaway on board. So now we have to go and hunt down that new rail car. And yeah, see, that's what happens if you step on the electrified rail. So we'll follow this path down. And I guess the Marine fell off the rail car. Kind of interesting. There's the rail car. Now this next part is rather interesting. What I do is I jump to the left side over here. There are many ways to handle this room, but the easiest way I found is to pistol shoot the two crates over there, so that they're completely destroyed, and then there will be three Marines running around the top level over there. They're far enough away so that they won't shoot at you. And the easiest way to take care of them is wait for them to stop running momentarily and then shoot them dead. Again, there's three Marines up there. In the source version of this game, I'm pretty sure the Marines will see you from this distance and fire at you, so be careful of that. This isn't the source version, this isn't a source walkthrough, so I may do a source version of walkthrough later on, but not right now. Anyway, there's still one more Marine to kill. Jump over the track to the right side and run to the right, because there's a mounted gun inside there. Easiest way to kill him is to toss a grenade over the sandbag wall and kill him, which he didn't die, but... Wow! He didn't die! Okay, this is getting a bit scary. And a bit stupid. One grenade left. Make sure this one counts. Yes! Okay, that usually does not happen, where he will survive that many grenades, but it did this time, so I hope you have enough grenades to spare. If you don't, you have to use this gun. If you have no grenades, just fire up in that and kill the Marine that way. It is a bit more riskier because you are susceptible to damage, but it's the only other option. Climb up the ladder, grab the guns here, grab the first aid station there if you need it. I don't believe there's anything in the crates, which there isn't, I was right. But there is a switch over here next to the sandbag wall, which will raise up the barrier arms so we can proceed with the rail car again. So let's do so. Alright, we approach another elevator, but we're not going to go up it again, because it's another trap. What we want to do is get off and head down this side passageway and grab some satchels from the crates. And one thing most people don't know, if you let the elevator go up, there's a satchel down there at the bottom, so drop down and grab that. Kind of interesting. Bring the elevator back down by pressing the switch again. Now this elevator, just like in a previous chapter I mentioned, is also glitched. Basically, your body will be stuck to the bottom of the elevator if it reaches the top. To counteract that, what you want to do is ride the elevator up and then jump as soon as the elevator reaches close to the top. I'll show you. jump, just like that, and you will avoid the glitch from happening. There is a lot of explosive crates, oh my lord. What you want to do is jump and throw a satchel. That's the only way to get the satchel through the crates, is to jump and throw it. Then ride the elevator back down. The glitch will not happen on the way down, by the way, so don't worry about that. And then detonate everything. Again, on the way up, jump as soon as it reaches the top. Jump. Just like that. Alright, there's a satchel down there. Grab that. And look who we splatified. A Marine who never saw it coming. Bust open the crates to grab an armor battery. And now comes a part that is a bit nerve-wracking to me, because I don't like heights, even in video games. But what you want to do is crawl your way over to this other side and jump through. Now there's a machine gun grenade. So since we have full of them, we can use one on that Marine down there. He never saw it coming either. So we killed him. Now we have to carefully make our way back down. Oh, gosh, I don't like looking down. Let's just continue onward. If you fall down, you take loads of damage. If not, die. We'll take the ladder down to where we killed that Marine and grab his machine gun if we need it. And now we'll go all the way up the ladder to the very top, where we can grab some supplies from the crates. Some magnum bullets, don't mind if I do. Go halfway down the ladder, then jump off back down to this area, and then take the elevator down again. Back down here, now we'll take the rail car and we'll ride the elevator up. Because we took care of all the Marines that would pose a threat to us. See, there's that dead Marine we killed with the machine gun grenade. And there's where we were with the machine gun grenade. Alright, so take the car forward and then crouch to avoid the electricity there. Just keep crouching. Remain crouched so that you won't take damage from those trip mines. When you round the left corner, stop the car. See those crates way off in the distance there? You can destroy the crates with the pistol because there are two Marines behind the two crates. And from this distance, they won't see you, like last time. So you can pick them off from this distance. Otherwise, if you take the rail car down, the crates will blow up automatically and the two Marines will be right in your face, and they'll cause lots of damage. So do it this way. You'll be much safer. Just crouch underneath the moving crates. You won't take any damage or get pushed off that way. But we stopped at another barrier arm. Basically, just crouch off the rail car so that you're out of danger, and then press the switch to raise the barrier arm. How simple was that? But getting back on the rail car can be a bit tricky because of, you know, these crates. They'll push you off. Time your run through, and then crouch jump onto the rail car, and then continue onward. We'll go up the incline here. And we come to another set of crates going back and forth. Don't touch these red lasers. They will activate turrets like these, which we will kill. Crouch under the crates again and continue forward. And destroy another crate, another turret to the left. And now it's safe to touch the red laser if you so desire to. It's not necessary, though. So now we'll continue on. There's nothing else of interest there. Crouch. Remain crouched. Yeah, there is a rocket launcher wielding Marine. If you stay crouched the entire time, he will not see you, which allows you to stop the car and get off. And believe it or not, you can crowbar whack him to death. When he's face to face with your awesomeness like that, he can't pull the trigger. That's right, you're too awesome for this guy. Get back on the rail car and continue on. We're getting close to the end of this level. Getting close. Crouch down again to avoid the high voltage of the electricity here. Oh, yes. Make sure to back up a little bit and shoot the red arrow to change the track. Because we want to head left and not, or, excuse me, we want to head forward and not left. If you let the car continue forward, it will just stop. We have to abandon this car again. And what does this say? Sector B, materials transit, I guess. So now we'll go down the ladder, since we have to abandon the car. Now down here, don't jump off the ladder. There's a red laser, and there's some trip mines. We'll go back up, and since we have no grenades, we use them all on that, machine gun guy. We'll just use a satchel, which is just as efficient. Be careful. Do not touch the red laser. What you want to do is get down low enough to where you can just jump off the ladder and avoid touching it, because touching it will get the attention of all of these turrets, and they'll all fire on you, which is no good. There's a couple of zombies inside this room, and I guess I shot out the glass. I didn't think I could do that. Just headshot the zombies. We haven't seen zombies in a while, have we? But they're still ugly as ever. And yeah, these, you can see the scientist's skull behind the headcrab. They're, like, the headcrab is so pinched on their head that they, you can actually see their skeletal features. So grab the grenades and the health machine inside there, and then you can destroy the turrets systematically with the shotgun if you so desire. It's not necessary. Now the reason why this elevator does not raise up so you can take the car down is because it's broken. So yeah, we have to abandon the car and continue forward. Ah yes, this area is a bit troublesome. There's a Marine way over there behind the sandbags. You can try and headshot him. There we go. Now, there is another Marine. He's manning a big gun. What I do is I jump across the track and rush against this crate and push it forward. And when it can't go anymore, bash it. There, now we're out of range of the big gun. Now let's hope it works better than last time. Toss a grenade inside. Really? I rarely run into problems with these big guns. Again? Okay, we're not having this happen. We're just gonna use the machine gun on you. There, you're dead. I wonder if there's a hole. There must be, because see the grenades. Oh, yeah. You mean you're telling me. Wow, that was well positioned then. Anyway, inside one of these crates, you'll find a laser trip mine, so grab that if you need it. I don't believe anything's inside this crate. Alright, so now we'll continue on. grab the health pack there if you need it. I didn't sabotage the experiment. Maybe someone else did, but I didn't. Gordon Freeman is innocent of any crime. That's why you two Marines will die for your assumptions. Anyway, once they're both dead, warning, extreme heat during launch, clear area. We're about to launch the missile, folks. We are almost there. Nothing inside that crate. Now, something interesting. There's sort of something that most people don't know. See that camouflage area up there? Believe it or not, there is a sleeping Marine up there. I kid you not, he's taking a nap. He is unalert to your presence. And you can kill him with bullets, or like I'm gonna do, with a, well, he didn't die. With a machine gun grenade. There he's dead, his parts came flying down. But yeah, he's up there. He will never be alerted by any noise. But he is up there. So go ahead and kill him. Grab the health pack up here if you need it. And grab the shotgun ammo from the crate. Go through the blast doors by pressing on the control panel. And then the next control panel. Now this area can be rather deadly, so be careful. There are three Marines in this room, and they're on the right side. You can try and sneak shoot the first Marine, just like that. And then you can try to sneak headshot the second Marine behind the sandbags. Oh, crap! Damn! Not cool. I can't stress it enough. The ones with no masks are the most deadly because they can launch machine gun grenades at you. So be careful of that. But once they're all dead, you know, half my armor is gone now, but that's okay. There's where the rocket will emerge from, but it's not yet emerged. Over on the left side, you can grab some supplies, and there's a gun here that you can use to kill the Marines, but once again, it puts you in an awkward position. Go through the next blast door. Now this part is probably the most nerve-wracking section in the entire map. You do not want to touch these lasers because they will activate these explosives. Oh god, I'm not looking forward to this. What you want to do is push the far right silver crate as far forward as it can go. Then jump on it and stand on the left side of it. I hope I don't die, because if you touch the lasers, you're dead. Position yourself to just to the right of the black box there, then, well, that's not gonna work. Then you wanna jump crouch on the stairs and press the right button at the same time, just like that. I'm so glad I survived. If you mess up, you will die, because if you don't press the right button, you will slide down into the red laser and the explosives will detonate. So it will take practice, so save before you try. And of course, there had to be radio chatter on top of radio chatter, but what he was basically saying was the Marine is feeling guilty, in a sense, about killing innocent civilians. But apparently they're not feeling guilty about killing Gordon, but they're both dead, so... Caution, avoid motion while retinal scan is in progress. And apparently they jammed the retinal scan to keep the doors open at all times. There's a health machine, use that if you need to. Satellite portal array. Satellite array status offline. Oh, so it's a portal array. A portal array basically means, well, when the rocket is launched, it will close any portals. I'm not sure how that would work, but it's fictional, so hopefully this will work. Let's head inside here. There's the launch button. Finally, we've reached the rocket launch button. And there it goes. All right, we've launched the rocket, which means now, hopefully the portal will close and the aliens will stop coming. Let's hope this plan works, scientists. I really hope so. Don't run back down the stairs. You will detonate the lasers. What you want to do is carefully jump onto this platform here. Yeah, they really made this so difficult. It's so easy to mess up. Especially with me being over 1 hour in recording. I would hate to mess up. Anyway, we'll continue back. And there's where the rocket came from. We launched it already, and now we'll go back through the blast doors by using the control panel again. A new passage to the left has opened up, so we'll go through it. And then down the ladder. We are almost done. All that's left to do is break open the crates to grab some supplies. Oh, my voice is getting a bit tired. But it's all worth it. I love Half-Life and I love doing these walkthroughs. It's all worth it. It really is, folks. And here is another rail car, a much better looking one in my opinion, but we're not going to use it. I know it's tempting, but the next chapter is just, it's just too tricky if you use it. So we're going to jump over it and continue on. Oh, I didn't want to fall. Come on, jump back on it. Really? There we go. Gosh. And that's the end. Oh my lord, that's the end of On a Rail. I'm Big Mac Davis. I will see you in apprehension, everybody. Take care of yourselves, and I'll see you guys next time.